another episode of Business Builders Corner. I am Mary Engelman, Executive Director of the Greater Farmington Area Chamber of Commerce, and today I'm sitting with Amanda Godward from Ecotelligent Homes.
There you go, Ecotelligent.
Oh my gosh, you've been a member for a while, and so I'm pretty excited about sitting here and talking to you about it. Tell us a little bit about what that is about and what you do.
At Ecotelligent Homes, we do energy audits and efficiency upgrades for residential and commercial properties. So we come in and we assess the building or the home as a whole system, figure out where you can get the best bang for your buck for the efficiency upgrades, and help you implement those solutions.
Now, you're the actual owner of this business, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, that's wonderful. I love women business owners. It's so cool. So tell us, what makes you unique about being in the community? I mean, I don't know a lot of people that do what you do.
Yeah, it is a newer technology. Mm-hmm. We have some competition popping up around the state, but really it's a newer technology in that we look at your building as a whole system before we come in and just implement one solution. Okay. So we're not just targeting selling you windows, for example, or a lighting upgrade for a commercial property.
Right.
We're really trying to solve your comfort problems
in
an energy efficient manner.
Oh my goodness. And tell us a little bit, because you said anyone can just go green, but this is a little bit more, isn't it?
Right. Yeah, we like to say just anybody can go green, but you should be smart and invest your money wisely and go Ecotelligent.
I think that's wonderful. So you've been a member. I mean, like, that was one of the first things you did. You came in and said, you know, I'm ready to join a chamber and get involved in the community. How has that benefited your business?
Yeah, earlier this year, my business hosted a ribbon cutting ceremony when we had our shop open up at Hills Tech Research Park.
So in Farmington Hills?
Yes, in Farmington Hills. So the chamber helped put on a ribbon cutting ceremony, which was a really fun event for us and a good outreach event for the community to learn about the services that we offer.
And I tell you, it was very impressive to walk through and get a tour of your building. It was absolutely lovely. And that's not even including the fabulous food that you served us.
So
the mayor talked about it for days, so that was good. How did you get into this business?
In my previous life, I was a mechanical engineer in the auto industry, and it just really wasn't that good of a fit for me. Just didn't really, you know, I wasn't a big gearhead, I guess. But I went out and I got a few various green certifications and found energy auditing, and it was a perfect fit. I get to use my technical background, heat transfer, thermodynamics, all that good stuff, but apply it in a way that can help everyday people and everyday business owners and the environment.
That's really amazing. I want to be you when I grow up. I mean, you're just smart.
Oh,
just
thank
listening
you.
To you. So that's wonderful. Well, until you joined our chamber, I had heard of like the energy audit. Is this a new technology? I hadn't ever heard of that. I mean, is this new?
Yeah, no, it is newer. And I think previously people were just kind of taking a stab in the dark at what would, you know, get rid of the drafts in their family room. Or maybe they needed new lighting in their office, but maybe they needed new windows. They just weren't sure. So they would just kind of guess. Now this really helps them solve the problem.
Wow, that's amazing. I'm definitely, you know, guilty of that, because you just, you know, put a blanket down and you just hope that it, you know, that's not really the smart way to do it.
Right, yeah. So you got to really get to the root of the problem. Right. And our diagnostic test equipment that we use, the blower door, the thermal infrared camera, they really help to find the source of the problem.
Right. How much can a typical homeowner or business owner save in your energy audits and efficiency upgrades?
Yeah, on average, our residential customers save roughly 40% on their utility bills. And commercial property owners can save 60% all the way right on up. I mean, once you improve your energy efficiency, then it's time to go to renewable sources.
Right.
And with solar panels, you have zero energy bills.
Now, obviously, you're based in Farmington Hills, which we absolutely love, but your reach is further than that, isn't it?
Yeah, we serve all of Southeast Michigan.
That's great. Mm-hmm. That's great. Are there rebates or any other incentives available for having an energy audit or making some efficiency improvements?
Yeah, absolutely. Both residential and commercial,
Really?
There's rebates available. Here in Farmington Hills, there's the Consumers Energy Rebate Program, Home Performance with Energy Star. That would be on the residential side. And then for commercial property owners, depending on what upgrade you do, you can get rebates from either DTE or Consumers Energy.
Oh, wow. So you'll basically help educate the homeowner or the business owner on the process and what they need to do to get these rebates and all that kind of stuff?
Yeah, exactly. And our company, we actually take it one step further. So we'll process all the rebate paperwork for you. And where possible, we'll offer it as an instant rebate.
Wow.
So we'll take it right off the bottom line.
Really?
Yeah, and then we'll be the ones that sit around and wait for the rebate check and not you.
So you're basically the one-stop shop. I mean,
yeah, you know, we're trying to be.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh, well, you have to come and visit my home because Lord knows we have lots of drafts.
We'd be happy to.
Yeah. So how long have you been in Farmington Hills?
I've lived in Farmington Hills for 8 years now, I think. Yep. Great. And then I started the company in 2009, so we've been here ever since.
Oh, my goodness. Well, we're excited to have you here. You know, you're sitting here and you're talking to the audience, really, in Farmington Hills and some of the surrounding communities. And, of course, you know, we're with the modern technology, we're on the Internet and so on. What made you choose this community? I mean, I know you've lived here, but, you know, you don't always live where you work.
Right. We are happy to be staying here in Farmington Hills. When I grew the company from just me and my home-based business into, you know, the brick and mortar with my staff, I knew we wanted to stay here in Farmington Hills where the local community was very active and mm-hmm. all the city leaders support sustainability initiatives.
Right, that's great. I would think that your services are more geared towards older buildings. Is there a typical age of a home or a commercial building that can benefit from more of your services?
That's true that older homes do and commercial properties can benefit, but also newer construction can benefit as well. In all honesty, you know, homes that were built in the 90s kind of got built really quick during the building boom and weren't necessarily built to the best of quality. So we've found several newer construction homes that we've been able to help. And especially on the residential side, it's more on a comfort situation. Right. So they have a new home, they're so excited it's less maintenance, but the kitchen's super drafty or the second floor is very hot in the summertime. Right. So we can help come in and solve those problems. Right. And on the commercial side, there's always, always potential to lower your overhead. Really, you know, get those energy bills down so you can invest that money back into your company.
Right. Well, what are your hours of operation?
Our office is open Monday through Friday, 4 to 8, and we can do energy audits. Typically, we do the energy audits during the week. Mm-hmm. And for commercial property energy audits, we can also schedule while they're off hours,
Great.
So we're not disturbing them.
Wonderful. Well, can you, I mean, what would you like to leave the community today? I mean, tell us something. And before you start, I have to say, I mean, just the thought that you opened up your business out of your home, and now you have this thriving business in Farmington Hills. That just says a lot about our community and how, you know, we have these entrepreneurs, and it's so exciting to sit here with you. But tell us, what would you like to leave us with today?
Well, thank you very much for that, and thanks for having me here, definitely. I think we're very excited to be here in Farmington Hills and be active with this community that can support our initiatives, both to, you know, improve the environmental quality here, but also just improve the quality of life. And we're very thankful for the community's support.
Wonderful. Well, Amanda, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Today is Saturday. Ha. Today is Saturday. Yeah. Salad on Saturday. Children eat well and move a lot, and move a lot, and move a lot, eat well and move a lot. 60 minutes of physical activity a day and eating well can help get your child healthy. So keep them active and eating well every day. Skip a rope Saturday, freeze tag Friday, tap dance Thursday.
Home greens Wednesday, dry a veggie Tuesday, let's move Monday, split the sweet Sunday.
Eat well and move a lot. Children. Get ideas. Get involved. Get going at letsmove.gov. That's letsmove.gov.
Welcome back. I'm Mary Engelman, Executive Director of the Greater Farmington Area Chamber of Commerce. For my second guest, I have Mr. Sean Spencer, who is actually at Home Care Solutions, and you are the director. Now, your title's long and very important. So tell me what this is.
Director of Business Development.
Okay. So basically, you're the boss.
I wouldn't say that, but someone that tries to help grow the organization.
Well, you know, Sean, I've had a tour of your place, so you've got to tell us, what is the nature of your business?
Well, we're a home health agency, and we're situated on the campus of Detroit Baptist Manor.
Right.
So it's a close walk or a short drive. Right. For the residents and for our clinical staff to meet with them. And we provide home health services,
right.
which is nursing and physical therapy, occupational therapy services, for our residents, mainly for our residents mm-hmm. at Detroit Baptist Manor.
Okay, and how long have you been in Farmington Hills?
Well, we just moved, we purchased the Home Care Solutions from that was located in Southfield. We purchased that business and then moved it to the campus of Detroit Baptist Manor in Farmington Hills.
Boy, we love
that.
In
April. So we moved it from Southfield
to Farmington.
You
moved it to a great community. I mean, what other community is there, right?
Absolutely.
Absolutely, that's great. And, you know, what made you choose Farmington Hills?
Well, that's where Baptist Manor is located, the main campus. Well, both of our campuses are in Farmington Hills, of course, but the main campus is at 13 and Orchard Lake. And so we have a doctor's office building right on our campus. So it only made sense for us to move our home health agency.
Right.
And so we redesigned the doctor's office and modernized mm-hmm. it. And that way our clinicians can come and go right from our campus be able to work with our residents mm-hmm. right there really close.
Absolutely. What makes you unique within our community?
Well, what makes us unique
right.
is that our sole purpose in what we did was to provide or be an additional tool right. for our residents at Detroit Baptist Manor.
Okay.
And we serve a population that is low income predominantly and also is a pretty high age level. And so this way we wanted something that was very close for them and that we could continue to be an advocate for them in an area where there's so much fraud. There's an enormous amount of fraud in the area of home health agencies. And so we didn't want our residents to be taken advantage of. And so this way, we thought if we purchased an agency,
right.
brought it in, we could have better controls and yet give the residents a better comfort level of people coming on the campus. They could come to our office
right.
at any time they want,
right.
see our staff. And so we're completely transparent, mm-hmm. yet advocating for our residents and everything that we do every day.
Well, and I know that you're right on Orchard and 13. And I tell you something. When I went back there and you took me on that tour, I couldn't believe how extensive and how complex your whole campus is. And it really is a self-sufficient area. So we thank you so much for supporting our community and choosing us. I mean, for whatever reason, you're just an asset to our community. So you've been, one of the first things you did was you joined a chamber. You know, how have you found that your chamber membership has benefited you, your company?
Well, like you said,
right.
when you... When I kind of gave you a drive around the tour,
right.
we're a 35-acre campus. And the biggest thing is giving us access and exposure
right.
to other people in the community. So if mm-hmm. they have a loved one or they right. themselves are looking for a place, a
mm-hmm.
Community that's safe
mm-hmm.
and something that would be from a low-income perspective, we're a tremendous opportunity for them. As well as there's
right.
a number of care continuum services that we offer.
Mm-hmm.
And this the connectivity that we had through you and the Farmington
right.
Hills Chamber has been huge for us,
sure.
from other individuals as well as with other business leaders as
Absolutely.
Well.
Well, and that's true. Every time I see you and I introduce you to someone, you get it and you're connecting and you're making things happen. And that's what we like to see in our membership. You know, why the campus of Detroit Baptist Manor?
Well, there was a doctor's office on this building that there was a private practice in there for
okay.
30 plus years. And the physicians that were in there were retiring. And so I spoke with the executive director, Elizabeth Gillespie, and I said, you know, let me help you. Let's try to capture that building because there's a huge piece of property that can be developed right in front
mm-hmm.
of it, which has frontage on 13 Mile.
Right.
And so a number of years ago, I helped her acquire that property, if you will.
Wonderful.
And so it only made sense for us to take and
put our
own
absolutely your stamp
agency
on it.
Right there,
definitely.
Right, exactly.
How do you see yourself making a difference? I mean, you've talked about all the wonderful things, but you know, when you look at yourself, how do you see that happening?
Well, one of the things I think that's really important, as I mentioned earlier, is the fraud that
mm-hmm.
is rampant in the home health agency is really it's really sad.
Right.
And so the area where we're making a difference, and we're going to start with our own campus, and
mm-hmm.
that's our focus, but as we broaden outside of our own campus and our own residents, it's being transparent and yet being open and having open houses and inviting people in to come see us and meet our staff, as
right.
well as let them know what we're doing and then
Absolutely.
Measure, be transparent in measuring how we're helping them.
Mm-hmm. And how does that play into your vision?
Well, what our point, one of the things we'd like to do is add other things in addition to the home health agency
okay.
that we have, Home Care Solutions, to our campus. We have a number of acres that are undeveloped. And so maybe adding some other things that from a therapy center or whatnot that would be a great addition for Home Care Solutions that could also be used in the community for other seniors that may not be a resident.
Absolutely. I mean, that's what I love. I mean, your vision, everything that you're doing is really to help the economy and also really protect the people that you serve.
Exactly.
It's good stuff, Sean. That really is. You know, how as the community of Farmington Hills, how can we get involved? How can we, you know, assist you?
Well, there's a couple ways that people can get involved. Number one is if they know somebody that they think would be like a tour or a for Detroit Baptist Manor, we'd be happy to facilitate that tour for them and their family member, even if they're maybe not in a position now. But there's a, you know, there's a fear of going to sometimes an independent living facility.
Absolutely.
So taking that tour. The other thing is volunteers. We would love people to volunteer their time to work with us at Home Care Solutions and the Manor help serve and facilitate advocating for our residents.
That's great. I mean, you know, and I know that there's a lot of communities, like community programs out there we can tie you into to get those volunteers. So is there anything special you'd like to leave the community of Farmington and Farmington Hills today?
Well, I think the main thing is that we're happy to serve. And if your loved one is a resident over at Detroit Baptist Manor, we're very excited and happy to serve them and really make sure that we're providing the level of care for them that they expect and that they deserve.
Great. Now, this is going to be a tricky one. What are your hours of operation?
Well, our hours of operation really are 7 days a week.
That's what I figured.
It's whatever our patients, you know, residents and our patients' schedule would permit. Mm-hmm. Our office hours are 8:30 to 5 Monday through Friday. But really, we're at the, you know, not the mercy, but we want to really work with whatever works best, you know, with our patients on our campus.
Well, Mr. Sean Spencer, thank you so much for joining me today. I mean, we've just learned a lot. And I tell you something, just the care and just your dedication to, you know, your business is just fantastic. So we're glad you're part of the chamber, and we look forward to having you there for a lot of years.
Well, thank you very much. I'm honored to be here.
Great.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to Feed the Pig.
Welcome back. I'm Mary Engelman, Executive Director of the Greater Farmington Area Chamber of Commerce. And I am so excited to sit with my dear friend, Linda Jackson, who is the Executive Director of, and I got to read this because if I get it wrong, I'm going to be in trouble. National Board for Certification and Hearing Instrument Services.
Sciences.
I can't even read today.
It's a long name. That's why we abbreviated.
So tell me about this. What is this about? I mean, you know, what is the nature of this?
Back in 1981, a group of hearing aid dispensers thought that there should be some standards that hearing aid dispensers should have.
Sure.
So they developed an exam and a certification for hearing instrument specialists. And that certification has become literally the standard internationally.
Oh, really?
Actually, it's the symbol of excellence for hearing aid dispensers worldwide.
So you're not just here, it's worldwide.
Our office is here in Farmington Hills.
Oh, yes.
But
say that again, Linda.
Our office is here in Farmington Hills.
Oh,
we absolutely love it here. In fact, it was supposed to be our temporary location.
Really?
We were looking for a building to buy, and we saw this location, and the layout was literally perfect. We have a wonderful landlord. We have just a great location. It was convenient. And we kind of unanimously all decided we should make this our permanent home. So we redecorated the office. We'll be here at least. We've got a 5-year lease.
That's
not up for another 3 years and an option for another 5. So
we're
planning to be here
Wonderful.
For a while.
So you've been here now for 2 years?
A little over 2 years.
Okay, that's not too bad. And, you know, obviously we talked about how you love Farmington Hills, and we're very pleased about that. So obviously what you do makes, I think, makes you unique, but what makes you unique in the community, and how do you, you know, how do you see all that playing in?
We're not just unique to this community, we're unique, period, because right. there isn't another company that do what we do. We advocate for our right. certificates, but we also advocate for the consumer, because hearing is precious.
Absolutely.
And when you have a hearing loss, we want to make sure that you see somebody that is board certified. Mm-hmm. You can find the people who are in the Farmington Hills community or any place that you're located. You simply have to go to our website, which is nbchis.com, right. key in your zip code, and you can find a board certified hearing instrument specialist pretty much any place that you're located, because they're in, even in the little, my dad had a hearing loss in the right. little town in Tennessee.
Right.
And I was able to find a board certified hearing instrument specialist down in, it was called Henning, Tennessee.
I love that. It's about accountability, you know, and I just think that's really important. Can you joined a chamber. Have you found your membership to be beneficial?
Well, one of the most beneficial things that I found about being a member of the chamber is you introduced me to John Petty.
Yes.
Who is the sales rep for CBS Radio.
Yes.
And we are currently working on a program that is national.
That's amazing.
That any of our certificates in any market that has a CBS radio station can participate in this program.
Wow.
And when I met John, John said, you know, he wanted me to advertise locally. And I kept saying,
You're bigger than that.
I need a national program.
Right. You're bigger than that.
I need a national program. So we kind of talked about it, and we came up with a co-op program where we will pay the production cost, and anybody that's in one of their markets can advertise so that the consumers can become aware that the BCHIS designation is what they should look for when they're looking for a hearing aid dispenser.
Now, is this, because you're the executive director, is this considered your headquarters, Farmington Hills?
Yeah, this is the headquarters. We're the only physical location for the National Board for Certification.
And that's, you know, again, going back to Farmington Hills, where we have so many of our corporate offices here, and, you know, the work you do all over the world comes back to benefit our community. And I think that says something wonderful about it. About, you know, this whole partnership. So, you know, how long has the National Board of Certification been in business, and why was it started? I mean, you know, I know that, you kind of talked about, you know, the doctors getting together and saying we need to create this.
Well, it started because these hearing aid dispensers, there was a time when hearing aid dispensers were not considered professionals. And to develop a standard for hearing aid dispensers was something that was very, very important and added credibility to not only the individual professionals, but to the industry itself.
Mm. That's amazing. You know, I know that there's a lot of people, even in my family, that are losing their hearing. So that impacts a lot of us, you know, people.
It absolutely does.
I mean, that's local. That's real stuff. So what makes this certification so important? I mean, if there are people that do it and don't, I mean, why is this important?
It's important because we think we know what we know.
Right.
Young kids think they can drive, but when they go to take their driver's test.
So there's some of these old kids.
So when they go to take their driver's test, they don't pass.
Right.
Because there's things that they think they know that they don't.
Right.
Well, the certification is basically doing the same thing.
Setting the standard.
It's setting the standard.
Wow.
And if you think you know what you're doing and you pass this exam, then you've got a level of confidence and professionalism
right.
that, yes, I'm a board yeah. certified hearing instrument specialist, and these are the minimum criteria yeah. that I know, so I know that I know what I'm doing.
That's great.
So it makes you prove that you know
right.
how to properly fit a hearing aid.
That's amazing.
Because unfortunately, if somebody has a hearing loss and they go to somebody who maybe is not board certified and doesn't have the quality of knowledge and the knowledge of technology that's available, if you can't hear and somebody improves your hearing 25 or 30%, well, you think that's great.
Right.
Well, what you don't know is you've missed another 60 or 70%
Absolutely.
That you could get to if you go to somebody that is board certified right. and has the knowledge to improve your hearing.
So how do you find these certified people? I mean, like, you know, I mean, because if, I mean, you look them up and on the internet, I mean, like, tell us, help us.
The key is to go to our website.
Got
All
it.
Of our board certified mm-hmm. people are listed on our website.
That's
you
perfect.
Key in your zip code, you will get a list of all of the board certified people in your area.
Okay.
And if you're looking in general for somebody, all you have to do is look for that BCHIS designation. That's behind their mm-hmm. name, like MD or BA.
Got it.
It is a designation that is, like I said, internationally known.
We need to tell people about this. So we're at the very end here of our interview. So real quickly, if a hearing instrument specialist or audiologist, oh my Lord, tongue twister, wanted to become board certified, what do they need to do?
They can go to our website. Okay. We have an entire section that is designed to give them a step-by-step
right.
process to become board certified.
Wonderful, wonderful. And
or they can call our office.
There you go. And what are the hours?
Our working hours are 9 to 5,
okay,
Monday through
perfect.
Friday.
Wow.
But people who know us know if you have our cell phone numbers, you can reach us pretty much.
And I have her cell phone numbers. Call the chamber. Just teasing. Well, Linda, thank you so much for joining me today. It has been such a joy to hear about like this really important issue. And folks, I mean, go to a board certified person. Do not just look them up in a phone book. That's not how we want to do it, right?
That's not how
That's
we want to do
right.
it.
Right. Well, thank you so much, Linda.
Well, thank you, Mary. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. And we will see you next time at our next Business Builders Corner show. This is Mary Engelman, Executive Director of the Greater Farmington Area Chamber of Commerce. See you next time.